Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at the Defocus tool, new in DaVinci Resolve 19. This is a super cool tool, I think. If you want to fake the depth of field, if you're using a camera or lenses that can't really create that look you are want to achieve, you've been able to do this before, but it required to do different things. And now it's just dedicated to DaVinci Resolve 19. And, you know, I think it's kind of cool. So let's just dive in and have a look at the tool in DaVinci Resolve 19. So let's go. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve having a look at the Defocus background tool in DaVinci Resolve 9. So this is a studio feature only. So if you do not have the studio feature, I did do a video on how to create this effect a while back, and I think you can have a look at that video right up here in the top corner. Anyway, and we're going to work with this little clip I have right here. As you see, this is totally in focus, and I want to do the background out of focus for this little clip here. And by the way, this clip is from a short film I created using artificial intelligence, a old film I never did finish before using AI. So anyway, if you want to watch that movie, you can have a look at that right up here in the top corner. It's a little fun thing, I think. So anyway, let's get right into the tutorial part of this video. So let's just jump right into the color tab in DaVinci Resolve. And we have the clip right here. So as you see, this is just a clip from the final film. So everything is graded and have effects and stuff like that. So we're not going to give it any grade or anything like that. So I'm just going to add in two new notes. I'm just going to push Alt S two times on my keyboard, and I have two notes. So in this note here, I'm going to use Magic Mask because I need to kind of isolate the foreground from the background so we can do the effect. So we'll just jump into the Magic Mask, and we're just going to use, I think the Object Mask is the most precise mask we have. So I'm just going to draw here on myself here, like that. And I think we should have a pretty good mask. We can just toggle on the overlay here so we can see what we did. I didn't get all of my hair, but I'm just going to take that right now. And then I'm going to change this into better. So we are having a way, way better track. So let's just track forward and backward. And DaVinci is doing a pretty decent job at this, I will say. It's super fast in the new version as well. So we're just going to have a look here. There we go. Cool. Looks pretty good. I'm just going to toggle off the overlay. And then I'll go into the other mask here. I'm just going to search DE. And there we have the defocused background tool. I'm going to apply that into the third node. And then I'm just going to connect the blue square to the blue triangle. Connecting these together. And as you saw right here, already we did have a change in the background, and we can go into the, find the spot, I think here. We can go in and we can actually see, change the background. So if we go all the way, you'll see it's going to do something with the widescreen bars, and that is because the widescreen bars are rendered into this clip. But we are going to fix that super fast just by going up to timeline, going into output blanking, and I'm just going to put the 240 on. And there, all this craziness is gone. And also think we, in the blur, we went a little too crazy. So we are just going to put it down a little bit. Something like that, maybe. And the cool thing about this is that we could actually use keyframes. So I'm just going to add in a keyframe here. And then I'll go to the beginning of the clip where I am out of frame. And here, I actually want to have focus on my background. So I'm going to do like that. And I've now done a quick animation where it changes the depth of field over time, very fast, of course, but looks pretty cool. Also, we could go in and in the advanced options here and make it look a little more anamorphic by
by changing the anamorphism, go in here and make it a little more like that. And then we could go into the highlights and mess around with that. Like something like that looks good. So let's have a look here. I think this looks pretty good. Okay, so that is how the defocus background tool works in DaVinci Resolve 19. I do know that this is a studio feature only. Just another example on why getting the studio version is a pretty cool investment in your editing software. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there is a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.